Alright, afternoon everybody. How are you all doing? Alright, cool. We talked to you all today about blockchain IT, right? Essentially, our objectives. Today we're going to be able to, of course, list job titles, identify job titles associated with, you know, various stages, eventually system development life cycle. We have different parts of it, there are different jobs for each stage, and essentially identify the responsibilities associated with those particular job titles, right? So we also want to take a look at, of course, a little bit of the nature of the work that people do, and again the skills, the technical and even a bit of the non-technical skills that IT people are supposed to hold. So have a little video for us to take a look at. But before I pull up the video, I wanted to ask if any of you all at any point in time, you know, wanted to like manage an IT department. Right? So you see, the face says no. Alright? Well, let's have a look at this now. Okay, so you're familiar with the show, the IT Crowd? Right? It's really about, same thing you were telling me about today. These two guys, they are, you know, very, very heavy into IT. And the manager, she basically got her job because at the time, you know, he was just looking for somebody to fill the management position. She knows absolutely nothing about IT. And she needed to make a speech as the IT manager. And she really didn't know anything about IT, and so she asked the guys to help her, and they kind of set her up. So let me pull it up here.
Bro.
So, obviously we have somebody there who's in IT, but, you know, kind of not into IT. This is what you shouldn't strive to be if you get into IT. And sadly enough, we know too much people like that, right? But in terms of jobs in IT, basically, you gotta get used to some, you know, titles, and you know, I'm just like, what does an IT manager do? Basically, you just manage the IT department, as we said before, managing people, sending people to do the IT, which is exactly what happens in this show. She gets a call, she never comes up, she just sends the guys out, right? And they do everything, and you know, unfortunately, in IT, the guys at the lower end of the spectrum kind of only find themselves doing everything, everything. So if you look at Moodle, I kind of have a IT job list. Right? And Richard was taking a look at it a little earlier. Right? And we can see that there are a whole lot of different IT jobs. Application developers, right, support specialists, help desk specialists, front-end developers, IT support managers, network architects, network engineers, right? And you have to figure out, you have to be able to figure out where all of these different jobs fall into, you know, the broader picture of IT. And the reality is that a lot of these jobs is that there's a lot of overlap at times, right? Sometimes the same IT support specialist might be a manager, might be a network architect, could be a network engineer, right? A database administrator might find himself also being an application engineer or a general network administrator, right? But, you know, other organizations, they have specific roles that you will have to fall into. Analysts and designers, you know, usually have multiple roles. Programmers, multiple roles. Network engineers, multiple roles as well. So, we're going to take a look at, you can't book basically at every job on that list, right? But we have some jobs that we want to go through. And right? Okay. So, just need to, right. Let's allow me 2 seconds to log into the site here.
But personally, I love it.
Basically, our programmer has to take a look at user specifications and requirements. We've seen detailed user specifications and requirements before, that's all. Mm-hmm. Yes, where? In the SDLC. Yes. Lifecycle, we're going to film lifecycle. Right? Yeah. So basically, what is gathered from the analysis stage of the lifecycle, right, is of course a design is come up and that design is sent to the computer program. Right? A programmer basically writes code, and so they encode, they test, they debug, document programs on a large scale. Right? So programmers love to do this part, love to do this part, love to debug. And then when it comes to the documentation aspect of it, they kind of write very little. Right? But really and truly that's a part of the job as well. They're supposed to revise and update the programs and also the documentation. Right? How many times will they use a piece of software and probably look for a particular, like some sort of help on it? And you can only get help for like a old version of the software. Right? What I meant is that whoever did the updating of the software really didn't update the documentation as well. Right? They write, test, maintain programs as we say, and they come up with logical structures for solving programs by computers. They have a little bit of sorry information too, and you know, what an average, I guess, American might make as a programmer. So programmers can make a decent amount of money, I suppose, as long as you get into the right company. Then we have web developers. So web developers are also like programmers, but their specialization is on the internet. Right? They program websites, they create application code, page links, content links. So essentially they manage whole websites. Right? Anything software related to the web. So again, pretty much similar to programmers, except that their focus is on the internet. So they also will have to have a little bit of knowledge of not just coding, but knowledge of internet technologies as well. Right? So the web developers, according to the National Survey, need a little less than regular programmers, but still pretty much decent salaries. Then you have systems analysts. And these are, you know, basically, they go by the name consultants in Trinidad, right? But what they do is they come in, they take a look at a particular system, how the business is operating, you know, what the business needs in terms of data, and they want to help the business develop some sort of system, some sort of computer system, or automated system to solve their problems, right? So they analyze, they evaluate, modify anything that currently exists. They might design, or they might just do the analysis part, right? They might code as well. It all depends upon, you know, scope of the project, and it depends as well as, you know, the size of the project and the size of the team. They might be just a specialist analyst, or they might be a multi-skilled analyst. So they design, code, test, debug, right? They might have, as I say, they might have programmers under them, or they might manage a small process. So a systems analyst is a kind of broad term in terms of IT. You could have a systems analyst, as I said, that just does the analysis. Or you can have a systems analyst that simply focuses on, that is kind of, I come in, I tell you, maybe they're like for a small business, they come in, they tell you exactly what you need, they might find a ready-made solution for you. They might find they might build a solution for you or get something to be tailor-made for your particular business. Right? Again, salaries probably are powered with programmers, but you know, more experienced ones get more money. Right? We have database developers and database analysts. And what they basically do is that they plan databases, they map all databases. We spoke about the entity relationship diagrams earlier, right? They are responsible for creating those diagrams if they are part of the design of the databases. They help develop the databases, they maintain the databases, update the databases, etc. Right? And with the data that is held within databases, they are also responsible for coming up with code to be able to pull that data out to be meaningful to whoever needs it. Right? So the database developer, and just to mention, the database developer will probably work hand in hand with a larger project with a web developer. So say for instance like the online banking, right? You will have the web developer who will develop the interface, etc. And the methods of being able to pull the data. But that web developer person will also need to be or need to work with a database developer or analyst. Right? Because the data is all held in the database, whereas the web person is just mainly focused on getting the data that will come from the database to be properly displayed to the user. Right? They have to come up with queries. So we mentioned that databases, we know that databases use structured query language, SQL, to be able to pull information out of it. Right? So a database developer does need to know a bit of programming, at least to be able to get whatever data they need to out of the databases. And while SQL is, you know, fairly simple in terms of being expressed as a language, the data that needs to come out of it could get very complex. So a database developer needs to be really familiar with the information that is inside of the database. They need to be responsible for backing up data in the database, archival data, right? Being able to recover that data and implementing that database. We have technical support specialists. They provide support to end users, right? Basically a help desk. Right? When you have a problem, you call, they assist you on common issues, right? I had to talk to a technical support specialist today about, sometimes it seems like the technical support specialists, they hire people who seem not to know about the system. I don't know. It's kind of like an introductory job, but it could be frustrating because I need help. And it sounds, when I'm talking to you, it sounds like you need help.
So
if you're not on the list, I can't help you. So, because this morning I spoke to one. And she was excellent. She was able to deal with my issues with PSCT and her phone and made an internet payment banking payment last week. And it didn't move through. And so PSCT took me the whole of last week. And I called the bank and the bank said, well, this unit has sent to TSCT. And so when I called TSCT, she walked me through everything. She just gave me one instruction. Right? She said, call. Call 1 hour from now and just, make sure that everything went through. She resolved the problem, but she's like, call 1 hour from now and make sure everything went through. And when I called him, this is who I got on to, the guy who I got on to in the afternoon, he sounded lost. You know, he was like, I started explaining the problem to him, he's like, well, where's the problem? Like, I tried to tell you the problem. Right? Yes, just like, I just want to know if the payment was applied. He's like, I keep seeing $800, but you owe $300. And I'm saying, okay, if I only owe $300, it means the payment was applied. But what is this you're telling me about the $800? He's like, well, I just given you a history. I'm like, all I need to know is whether I owe $800 or $300. He's like, well, eventually I sorted it out with him, man. He tell me I owe $300, but I have in the back of my mind of feeling that I'm going to the STT and tell him that they still didn't find the payment. TSC, did you sell all of them? I don't know. They just frustrated. Well, I think I got that same guy I spoke to this morning. Sorry, this afternoon. I think I got him this morning first time, and when I started telling you my problem, I suspect he had a problem. Because like he didn't just want to deal with that. So you can get some bad ones, you can get some good ones. Typically, you know, when you have technical support specialists, people call it hard issues, like I suppose I do today, right? Part of the job as a technical support specialist is you're supposed to research the job. Every new challenge, every new problem that comes in is a new challenge that you're supposed to... Well, that's it, because the girl was excellent. She's like, I understand the facts, and don't worry, we'll take it to me and be happy. I'm like, yes, you are excellent at this, right? And then I'm like, well, I want to verify the guy is you for this. Just pretty much everything that was good with the customer service this morning, he just came and wrecked that to me. So, you know, you have good ones, as with any job here, you have good ones and you have bad ones. So we have also quality assurance specialists, which essentially, as the job says, Yeah, just ensure that, you know, sleep. You might call them specialists at that point, but specialists might be the ones who come up with a list of activities to do to make the actual testers run through, right? So the quality assurance specialist would be the person who comes up with the plan, but then you would have the other people who would be in, testers themselves.
Yes.
So essentially, you know, once you win any kind of alpha testing, beta testing, you're part of the QA process, right? So this person, however, as I said, you come up with test plans, and we maintain, of course, test automation. Sometimes you come up with procedures to test the system automatically, or you come up with different processes to test the system, right? They come up with the quality assurance standard, so they say, okay, from these tests, I should have these specific set of results. And when you actually do the test, they will match them against the results and say, okay, what you're producing is up to standard, or what you're producing still needs help in these particular areas. Right, so they have whatever particular metrics that they use to measure how good an item is in terms of quality. And then we have probably the most popular Trinidad IT job around, network administrator. Right, and Trinidad network administrator pretty means much means everything. Right? Yeah, some places just have like an IT manager and two network administrators and that's it. A network administrator is helpless. Network administrators is web specialist. Network administrators, you know, testing and database person and all of that. But really and truly, in the purest sense of the word, A network administrator is supposed to install, configure, and maintain an organization's network. Right? And by that, we mean they are, you know, they pretty much set up and keep the computer systems, not just the computer systems, but the information system that's probably associated with it, and apps and stuff like that working. Right? So they have to build network and maintain external and internal web presence. They administer the network. So if the company has a website, they will be responsible too for maintaining and ensuring that our website is up. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that they will be a web developer. But they have to ensure that the hardware that allows somebody outside of the organization to access the network, right? They have to perform system backups. We talked about backups, different types of whatever backup strategy that they choose to implement on its internal and external web network servers, right? We have they're supposed to design and support server systems. So they do the purchasing, or they might identify what needs to be purchased and say, okay, well, this is what the organization needs for whatever needs to be implemented, right? In terms of backend hardware and client hardware, in terms of what the regular people and users would be using, and in terms of what we need to support them to do their job. Right? And this sounds like a whole lot of work, so probably more than everything else. And look at that salary. Boom. So far, it's pretty much one of the good salaries that is listed. Alright? So yeah, the network administrator gets stuck with a lot of work, pretty much in terms of maintaining and carrying for the network. The network administrator has to be very, very knowledgeable of the network. Again, things like ensuring that the clients' logins and all of that are maintained, covering passwords for people, ensuring that people have access only to what they supposed to have access to, right? That's what network administrators do. And we have security specialists. These people maintain systems to protect data from unauthorized users, right? So again, this job might fall into being a network administrator as well. So they also have to they resolve any kind of security violation, right? When you become a specialist, of course, this is what your job is, but to do it at a really, really high level. But as a network administrator, when you build a network, chances are you're responsible for your own security as well. For larger companies, they will bring in somebody who is a security specialist to ensure that their systems are secure, right? Because we know there are people out there whose hobby it is to just simply take down computer network systems. I remember a couple of years ago, Massa was hacked or something, so by some random group that they find an exploit on Massa's web front or something, so and they took it down.
Take down it?
Serious?
Yeah.
Well, sites like Blizzard and PlayStation and all that, they need to make sure that they write up with security.
Because
they shut down our service.
And they...
But they took down the StarCraft?
They took
them anyway. Okay. Can't tell the last time I played the game because I... I spaced that graph so long since I'm looking forward to August and just spend some hours on that. Alright? But yeah, so your security specialist is that. right? And they didn't have the answer of the security as well. You know, they, in terms of security, you know that they had eventually get into the airport, right?
Yeah,
the
company check. I ran had a system hacking
thing. Yeah.
It was some country in the
Then they changed the security chip in it. They have a wrong chip in it. That's the same chip that if you get it wrong 10 times, it would allow you to, it would wipe the system. What they do is they swap out the chip. And so then they run until that chip didn't return the signal that would send the signal to the iPhone to wipe it. And when they get that code, they put back in the chip and was hell. Which they could have done all the times. Right? Right, so we have messaging specialists as well. This is not physical messaging, right? We have this person who is the commercially available email project, collaboration project, right? So say for instance your business, you want to increase communication across your business, you get a messaging specialist. They monitor all of the operations and system status of the mail gateway and directory exchange function. Right? They of course migrate users from one email platform to another. So this person is really and truly involved in hosting understanding how email systems work. And because organizations might move from one system to another system, because maybe the current system they have, they're growing and they can't keep up with the demand, maybe it's not working properly, right? Maybe their service is just possibly bad. You don't want to lose all of your old emails when you move from one system to another. So you hire someone who really understands email, who understands how computers, you know, interact with each other and the formats that this mail must be stored in, right? And so they deal with all of the problems, they debug problems when email problems occur, right? And again, what are the network administrators? Little senior positions in terms of a company. Right, so we have application development managers who basically oversees systems analysis, and programming, and also they maintain, of course, new systems and programs, right? They're basically a supervisor. And then we have the IT IS manager, right? That we saw in our video just now, directs and coordinates activities in the IT department, really and truly responsible for the day-to-day management. They'll supervise the staff, right? They deal with vendors, they have to handle the budgetary and financial aspects of the IT group, right? We forgot to put a slide up here that says generally, typically, who is the least about information technology. I don't write that in the exam. You're going to say I teach you that, and then a whole bunch of questions are going to start from there. Right? So keep that last point to yourself. We will go back and tell the IT manager and move myself. Right? I have a teacher saying you know squats. Okay? But your IS manager, typically, your manager is for the IT department. It acts kind of like an intermediary between, of course, the board and people working for them. In some situations, in terms of managing what the people working for them would identify as needs and what they could take to the board and get from the board to ensure that everybody in the organization, could benefit, right? Again, treat IT people like magicians sometimes, though. So, you know, they expect them to just keep upgrading old computers and making them work and all that. I'm seeing no sympathy on your faces. We have the Chief Information Officer. For large organizations, they're the top information systems or IT executive for an organization, right? Again, they mostly involved in planning, right? And implementing items to maintain company operations, and they make a lot of money because they are managers. Right. So that's it for the first part with respect to some of the jobs looked at, but some of the jobs that I'm going to go through with you. Now I have with you guys, I'm gonna do, if you're in Moodle, I would like you to just simply go to the jobs in IT section. And we have some flashcard exercises. Oh, no. Right, we have some flashcard exercises. It's going to take us to our site.
Data analyst, right? They would have to do the reports and whatnot.
and the report writer. So yeah, basically it's a subset of the whole database administrator. So we're on the fourth button if you're with me. Alright. Title token, Richard, you can read off first.
Understanding about database requirements and translate those into specific database solutions, create data design models, database architecture, and data repository design. Work with the system and database administration staff to implement, coordinate, and maintain enterprise-wide data architecture. Provide leadership in establishing and documenting data standards, create and test database protocols.
Right, let's say it's something to do with your database, right? It's a data architect. So these are some real technical ones, but I wanted to just simply, you know, have them for you all to be able to reference. You can always come back to the center, and you can also, when you're studying, when you're reviewing, you can watch it. Pick on both sides and get the aim and the what it is at the same time. Right? The reason that the one side says Chinese and the other side says English, I don't know how that happened, but I'm English. But I'm not sure if I made a mistake and clicked on language something for, you know, translating Chinese to English for this one. But, you know, it's the first time I'm using it. And, but don't worry, the Chinese side is the answer and the English side is the next one. Right? So let's go about five more and then we will see. I'm gonna shuffle them, right? So that we'll get everything in winning order. So web developers, engineer, internet specific software, but I think this is web developer. This one it came up in the answer. Right, internet-specific software to post and update information on websites. Instead of looking in a programming language, they use HTML and JavaScript. Right, and integrate pages of text, images, and hyperlinks for sites and tools to use. No, I didn't quite like it. What your views on HTML?
Huh?
HTML and JavaScript?
They have easier to see.
So, this job, take initial telephone or email inquiries and troubleshoot, and I shuffle it so it won't come up the same as you. Right?
And
tech support?
Yeah.
Right? So yeah, help desk is tech support. So you are correct. I think we did this one on set, no? Right? Document the specifications, design features and operations of applications. Write and edit user manuals. Did you do this one too? This was the tech writer. Alright. It's also not the data writer actually. But the tech writer is, of course, focus on the creation of documentation, which is essentially, again, as I mentioned, sometimes when the programmers write up their system, the programmers are so focused on building the system that they don't really focus on developing the documentation to go along with it. And when we are in the SDLC, right, we have different types of documentation. We have two different types of documentation. Anybody help me out here? Two.
User.
Right. For the end user.
The end user and then for
right, so for the developers, actually one more. Yes, sorry, I meant three. We have the developers, the end users, and the. You what? But somebody has to write the, for the testing also. For the technical people who will be implementing or installing the software. Right? So you have technical documentation, developer documentation, and end user. I was actually kind of just looking for the technical and the end user. Right? The developer documentation is where if I as a programmer start creating something and I should have documentation along with my creation. So another programmer shouldn't have to come and kind of read my code to understand what I was doing. They could just simply read the developer documentation so that they could get an idea of what I was implementing and that would be understanding the code easy. Right? No self-respecting programmer does that. So a lot of programmers have the mindset of, well, I'm a very good programmer. Every programmer who comes up and is good too, they can read my code and misunderstand. Don't do that when you become a programmer. Right. So create, modify, and delete user accounts, monitor system security, respond to security incidents, participate in security system testing, ensure integrity and confidentiality of sensitive data. Basically the security specialists, right? And security and system administrator. Same thing. It's about the same thing, different type. Right. Security is a specialization, yeah. Right. They have different aspects of security. They have like a general security. They have what you call like you can become like a certified ethical hacker, which is where you get paid to compromise but list where the weaknesses are, right? Yeah, because the company hires you to kind of attack their system. But you're not destroying anything, you know? Let me not use the word attack, right? To find the weaknesses in the system.
And people
just
do it sometimes and then sell the information to the company. If they pay for the sometimes, right.
But that's
not that's
illegal.
Yeah.
Right.
That one is illegal.
Yeah, but that's
we find faults in the system and set it up.
Yeah. What other hackers in the amount of money is using what you call ransomware, where like if your in terms of security, if it is that your security system is not good in place, they're not really destroying your data, but what they're doing is that they will run something that will encrypt the data. So you can read it, and then they'll send you a message saying, well, we'd like it to be $25,000 if you want to get back your data. Right? And, well, I mean, they're already in, you know, they see the data, they have to really kind of present.
When they use the internal Wi-Fi system to take control of it by the personal driver, and they have it. They were showing it online.
Yeah.
So they showed the personal driver they have it, and then they took control of it using the internal Wi-Fi.
Wow.
Shut down the car, speed up, control everything.
That's scary. That's easy way to kill somebody. Okay, now somebody or something, so.
Yeah, they have
to be controlled.
They have
to be nothing. I don't trust those cars to be built in Wi-Fi or that. Right. Let me do this. Yes. Right. Right, well, this one is a definition for a systems analyst. Right. He's the middleman. He assesses the need of the end user, translates them into programming or working with other departments to develop the program, right? So essentially a system analyst finds out the business requirements as we identified when we talked about the SDLC. We also had who will comprise the user community. We wanted to say how large the application is going to be, will it be internal or external, and the system analyst finds this. Does the requirements gathering, remember that? Requirement specification and the functional and non-functional requirements.
Yeah.
Right. Implement network security policies and procedures. Administer maintain firewalls. Manage, monitor, and update virus prevention systems. Monitor security advisory groups to ensure all necessary network security updates, patches, preventive measures. This is another security job, right? Security administrator. Can we do this? No, do not. Right? The data modeler. Right? When you are designing the system, this person, the data modeler, comes in the design of the system, right? And what they do is that they will find the organizational data requirements and come up with, I'm sure I did a little mock-up of an entity relationship diagram, and they use another tool, other tools like data flow diagrams and context diagrams, etc. to essentially show how data will flow through the system, right? So that the people, who have to build the system will know exactly what they're building. So that's why I'm saying that they make the recommendations and they work with database administrators and reporting teams to ensure the availability of standard and ad hoc data reporting in a production environment. So the data modeler comes up with how the data is going to be created. Again, as I said, there are lots of different titles out there. But generally, one IT person who falls into the field, once you study security, you're going to find that you kind of fall into three or four different security roles. You might be the person implementing, the person who modeling the security, the person who testing the security, right? If you're a network administrator, right, you pretty much might find yourself, as I said, to be jack of all trades. If you're a web developer, chances are you can't get along unless your focus is web designer, which is more or less web designer, which is more or less coming up with the look and feel of the website, right? As opposed to web developer who comes up with the code associated with the website. What is going to happen as a web developer is that you pretty much have to understand how databases work, because you're going to have to be interfacing with databases, right? A database administrator will probably have to be some sort of data modeler and also analyst to the database as well. So it's not just one job, unless of course you're working for a very, very large organization which have been a very, very specific role, because there is that amount of data or work to deal with in that one single capacity. But typically, on a smaller level, you kind of do more than one thing, right? Now, you have been wanting to get into IT now again? No. That's all.
Can you do that?
Richard and me will be in the time.
Richard and
I want to pay salaries. Huh? Richard and I want to pay salaries. What? No, that's US salaries. But it might translate the dollar for dollar into the
math. I was still part of IT. My school is just
Yeah, they have a big IT. Where am I? me about the jobs in the skills associated with particular jobs in IT. This is a quick section, right? Again, if you are in it, we have the employability skills. And you might, this section, skills are transferable. Actually, these are skills that everybody should have. But there is a year that they ask, what are some of the skills that an IT manager should have? And some of the skills that they were looking for. You all pull it up? Yep. So you all put it up on your machines, right?
Top
10 employability skills. Run in it again. Just this.
Yeah.
These are general skills, as I mentioned. We're just going to run through them quickly. Less than 10 minutes. We have, first of all, communication skills, but when they ask you to list the skills associated with, or if they ask you that this year, you have to be able to relate it to an IT job perspective, right? So where does communication skills come in with respect to a particular job in IT?
Technical support.
Tech support especially, right? As we are saying, with the example of me and the TSCT today, she was able to talk me down after I spoke to the first bad person in TSCT and bad people at the public bank. Right? She was able to talk me down, deal with the situation, say, okay, well, I'm about to deal with it. The best, you know what I always find is the best thing that somebody is doing when they deal with me? It's just simply don't tell me you'll deal with it. Tell me, just tell me, hold the line. I'm dealing with it right now, but don't put on to music. Just let me hear you working in the background. Even if you just, right? You're doing absolutely nothing. But the fact that you can tell me that and just, kind of give me the impression, when you put me on hold, it makes me feel like I'm not going to get you back. That's what goes on in my mind. Or I don't know how long I would be on hold. I'd rather be able to say, still there, yeah, I'm still here, I'm looking at it. That just simply, TSDS, TSDD sound, right?
Again, next thing is teamwork,
right? Teamwork. Where would we have to come across the teamwork in IT jobs? Well, let's go with programming. Sometimes as a programmer, you're not working alone as a sole programmer, you're working as a team of programmers. So what happens is that you work on a specific part of the project and other people work on other parts of the project. And so you have to be able to, and again, communicate with them, and teamwork, you all have the same goal, you all live in an entire system. Or even as a programmer working with probably or building systems for a particular company, you have to be able to talk to the database administrator. You have to be able to talk to, because you'll be working with them for a period of time, probably the network administrator and the IT manager of that company as well. And all of you have to share the same goal. Right? So you have to be able, as they say here, to bring out the best in others. Right? So if you're co-workers, I don't know if you can do this, you're like, yeah man, don't worry about it. We might be late, but it will come true. Right? Third one, very, very important. Where this one will come into play, analytical and problem solving skills.
That would be any kind of
Any kind of analyst, anybody who looks at a system, right? Database analyst, security analyst, programmer, must have analytical skills, must have problem solving skills, right? You have to be creative. There's more than one way to solve a problem. Personal management skills. So you're managing yourself, right? Well, that's across the board, right? This one is the ability to manage multiple assignments and tasks and set your priorities.
Programmers.
Right? They are programmers because sometimes they have more than one task to deal with. Helpless people too need it as well, because sometimes you have a smaller issue, right? Somebody call and say, you know, well, my whole computer system stopped working. And another person say, well, I can't print right now. Well, you might just be able to do it in terms of managing those two tasks and say, well, let me just, you know, let me go talk to the person who printed and see how badly they need this printer, and then one deal with the person and change the entire system, because that might take longer. Right? So you might have to work out this and set priorities, being able to deal with your work assignments. Right? Number five again, interpersonal effectiveness, right? That kind of ties in with the teamwork. Number six is 100% for jobs in IT, right? Computer or technically literate. And again, brings me back to the example of, you know, going in or calling into a help desk and telling them the problem, and it's seeming like they don't know, you know, the problem could possibly exist as an option for something to go wrong, right? And again, coming back, I don't want to bash TSTT, but I always remember when I had TSTT, all I called was, the router was working, and all I called was to ask them, I think it was like DNS information or something, so for their router. I'm calling the person, and the person goes, starts with me. Is the router on? Can you try unplugging it, back in? Right? And I'm thinking to myself, why are you going through this list with me when obviously you could tell from me I'm talking that I'm technically literate, and you're supposed to be technically literate. Right? I'm just like, you know what, put me on to somebody who.
Right.
Well,
so
with
the solution
that
is
given, Tinder. Yes.
Most of
us have something. Right. Why? Right. And then we have leadership management skills for the IT managers out there. Or not even IT managers. Sometimes you might just as an IT person have to take charge when it comes to something in your specialty. So you might have an IT manager, but the IT manager is not particularly strong in networking aspects. The IT manager might be more of a systems analyst kind of person. And you have a particular area that comes up regarding networking. You would have to be the head of that. You would have to stay in that part. Number eight as well, learning skills. You have to be able to learn on the fly. Remember when we talked about network? Helpdesk technician just now. I mentioned the helpdesk technician needs to be able to, every problem they have somebody with, they need to learn from it. Because the next time somebody calls, it should be a little easier to help somebody. I don't mean sometimes there are people who kind of help you and then discard the information. Academic competence, reading and math, well, this one is a basic one, right? And strong work values, again, very basic. But we've identified some really, really good ones that relate to IT in terms of not just technical capability of doing the job, but in terms of actually being employed in IT, right? What they should have as an employee. So what I want us to do at this time just to round off the class, is to for about 20 minutes, let's just take a look at a couple questions in the remember the section of past paper questions I have. Yes, you can find it in the news forum on the Moodle. Not this one, sorry. This one. Right? If you go down to number 7, we have staff and skills needed for IT. Right? Let's just try the first 3 or 4 questions. So the first 3 or 4 questions of the jobs and skills, you all see them? When you went to the Moodle, it's in the news forum. For my subject. Now, go back up to Moodle. Oh, yeah, good. Sorry, I did that before. I went. Good. My courses. Right. So we went down to section 7, and let's just attempt the first 3 or 4. Let's go for 4 now. And so I'm gonna give you all 15 minutes, and then we'll just discuss it and put it off there, right? Yes. Is that open?
The Microsoft Office 2010 will probably try using 2015,
I don't know. Something with it here.
2015. Yeah. It does have an early activation. I don't want to say that was on it. comes to Africa.
Entering the meter. Right?
What?
It's a good point still be able to do some retrieval or maybe even a little bit of verification on the data. But the data entry is just simply taking what's on the form, putting it in. Responsible for the overall running of the company's IS department would be the manager and the IS manager. Yeah. Right? Producing slow code for a user application would be a programmer or a program designer. Right? Repairs computer hardware when it's when the malfunctions.
A
computer technician or a hardware technician. Right, and allocate user ID and passwords to users of a network would be the network administrator. Right? So we have five responsibilities of a systems analyst slash designer. Five old responsibilities. Seem like they're asking for a lot, right?
Yes.
Right, so we came up with any?
As some analysts, we have to be able to
That's an easy answer, right?
You need to be able to pinpoint errors in the system and point it out to whatever.
Right, yeah. So they have to be able to identify errors or problems into the system. So that's where the analysis comes in, right? The system analyst also has to come up with the requirements for a new system. The systems analyst also has to come up, they have to perform a feasibility study to say whether or not it makes sense to pursue a new system or give a recommendation as to what type of system the company should invest in. The analyst also, or let's jump to designer. The designer typically comes up with the blueprint of the system in terms of how the data should be stored, and they also need to come up with a map of how the system data should be passed through the system. Because we know that the output of the system is the DFD, which is the data flow diagram, which shows how data passes through the system, the proposed system, and also how data should be stored in the system, which is the entity relationship diagram. So it maps how data is stored in the system, and it specifies how data is processed by the system, and who interacts with the system. Right? So identify the stages involved in the process of creating a new system. This is actually not really too much of a jobs in IT question, but it's a seems that they just ask about the analyst and designer. This should give you a clue as to what we're talking about here. Yes, this is a system development lifecycle question. So the stages of the SDLC would suffice here, right? Planning, analysis, design, implementation and testing and maintenance and feedback and review where necessary. Right? And last question, identify four things that a member of a network support team might be expected to do as part of their job.
Network support team, that would be kind of like the support queries of the people in the company.
Yeah, so basically handle help desk queries is one. What else would they do?
Well, of course, issue solutions.
Right. Because they might implement something, so they have to show people how to do it or assist them. What else? Right? They would actually as well have to fix. They might be expected to fix actually hardware that is connected to the network and also set up software. Set up the network, hardware and software. So when you get to the answers, don't say set up Admin-T, because you're giving two answers in one line and you're kind of shooting yourself in the foot. Right? Set up network in terms of configuring and installation and maintenance in terms of repair and fixing on the software side. Right? Updating software, etc. So you get two answers there. Alright guys, well that's it. I hope that you all learned something today. I hope it wasn't so bad. Those are shoes, you see. Alright, nice people, right? But, yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. Alright, so I'll see you all next class. Anybody have any questions before we leave? Or that's it. That's it? Alright, well, God speak. You first answer what you. Right? I will see you all. I don't know if Saturday yet, but we'll see.